Bring in News Nation's Brian Enten, who's been on stakeout out in front of the laundry's house for days now. And a whole lot of people have joined you in the last day or so, Brian, with bullhorns, and they are angry. Set the scene for me.
Yeah, it was wild tonight. About 5, 6 o'clock, I would say about 50 people showed up with bullhorns. They started shouting, "We want to know where Gabby is. Come out, Brian. Come out, Brian." And they were relentless. They didn't stop for, you know, an hour or so. And then it was so interesting. You mentioned it. Out of nowhere, a black van pulls up. Two FBI agents get out. They go into the house. A short time later, another police car shows up. Two more detectives go into the house. We weren't sure what to expect. We didn't know if they were going to bring Brian Laundrie out. We didn't know what was going to happen. About 3 hours go by. They bring evidence in and out. They search a car. 3 hours go by. They leave. And then, bombshell, we find out that Brian Laundrie is now missing.
So, Brian, this is what I want to figure out here. I can see them going in and out of those doors. I don't see a warrant. I don't know if anybody saw a warrant. Were the police invited in, allowed in, or did they have to bring that formal piece of paper to say, open up?
No, it is our understanding that Brian Laundrie's parents called the police and requested that they come here because they wanted to talk about Brian Laundrie. That is what we heard earlier today. Now, putting the pieces together, they wanted to talk to the police because their son is now missing.
So the other question, when you were doing your live reporting just moments ago, we saw some of the officers come out and ruffle through the back of a van, and then they just walked back into the house with some very small evidence. It looked like evidence bags, not the kind that I would have expected. I would have expected big, huge bags. Do we know if they came out with those bags full, bulging, anything that might have looked like, I don't know, cell phones or laptops or anything like that?
So they weren't bulging, and they were small paper bags, almost like what you would get at the grocery store. And they came out with two of them, and they weren't bulging at all. You'd almost think there was paper inside, maybe a cell phone, but nothing. I mean, we were out on the street. They were keeping us back. Nothing that you could see bulging or anything like that. So it wasn't like a large item.
So I always wonder about line of sight when you're on stakeout, as you have been. I know there's a lot of fast food in your car because you've been there for days. Did you ever see Brian Laundrie actually in that house or go into that house? And obviously, you didn't see him come out. So let's start with the, did you see him go in?
We have never seen Brian Laundrie at this house, and we've been here for about 4 days, almost around the clock. What's interesting, we were on your show last night, we finished up, we were getting some more videos, sort of just keeping an eye on the house again late into the night, and my photographer and I were talking, and we came to the conclusion there is no one in this house. There's no one that's been here for the day. It was pitch black last night. It's a small house. There was no light even coming out of any of the windows. I'm like, somehow this family is gone. So I was frankly shocked today when the FBI showed up at the door, and I thought no one's going to answer the door, and then the door just sort of cracked open, and the first thing I said is like, oh my gosh, there's been someone in the house. So we don't know if the parents and Brian have been here for days, and maybe Brian snuck out a back door or a back window and no one saw, or if Brian has just been in another location and the parents realized that he's now missing.
And I'm just trying to orient myself behind you there. There's a pickup truck behind you. Does that belong to the laundries? Is that their driveway?
Yeah, let's walk around, Luis. Just bear with me because there's a lot of reporters out here, so it might not be the prettiest shot, but it'll give you a better orientation here. This is the laundry house right here. And you see the pickup truck, you see the camper, there's a police car in front, police officer, and then you see that silver Mustang. That's interesting because after they took out the two brown paper bag evidence bags, then the police went to that Mustang, opened the side door, took something out of the Mustang, and then opened the trunk and took something out. So apparently the Mustang is also significant in some way, Ashley.
And so the officer that I saw behind you that's standing near the Mustang, is he effectively on crowd control because of the protesters, the media? I saw a whole lot of people all over their lawn as well, which is property. Are they basically staking out and staying there to keep people from doing anything else?
station. It seems like that's the case. It's really quieted down out here tonight. There's maybe like a dozen people compared to when the streets were packed earlier. But yeah, it seems like the police are just sort of out here keeping an eye on things. And some of the neighbors have wondered, I mean, if Brian Laundry is missing, is it possible that he could show back up here? I mean, is that why? It's not just that officer. There's other officers on the block, all stationed. I mean, is that a possibility? Could he show back up out here?
Well, yeah, when you're looking for someone, that's usually how officers do it. They find the people closest to them and they monitor them nice and tight. Can you do me a favor and just orient me to the tour you were taking us on down the other way? Like, there seemed to be a lot of press, and I just wanted to get a feel for, I don't know, the frenzy that it seems to be. This story just seems to be captivating the nation.
Let's back up 1 second, Luis. Let's wait for this van to go by, because it's a rural area. I mean, it's dark out here. This is not like inside a city at all. So we'll back up and we'll kind of give you the shot here. You see there's about a dozen people out here now. Again, the street was full earlier because people thought Brian Laundry was inside, and that's when they were chanting. You've got the laundry house right here. And then if you look in this direction down the street, you've got more media. And then walk over here with me really quickly. I want to show you this because this is sort of relevant. And again, it's so dark, but if you look down the side of the house, it's a small house. And you can see there's sort of lights on in the background there. There are other homes behind this house and then a street. And some of the neighbors have suspected that if Brian Laundry wanted to get out and avoid all of the media, he could have gone out a side window or out a back door, just gone through an empty lot back there, and then ended up on another street where there's not nearly as many people.